We've been talking quite a lot recently about WebAPI, and so I thought this week we'd look at the idea of WebAPI versioning. So if you've already published your API, you've got customers who are using it, how we can then modify that, not by making any changes to the existing API, but by producing a new version so that those clients who want to use a new version can use it, those who want to stick with the older version can stick with it as well. So let's have a look at what we've got for that. And what we're going to do here is use the application that we were using over the last few videos when we're demonstrating Swagger and things like that. So it's pretty simple. What we've got is a SQLite database. We've got an entity called book review that just has an ID, a title, and a rating. We've got a load of those reviews already in the database. We've got entity framework and a DB context connecting it all up. So just look at the early videos for the details of that. But then we've got our book reviews controller. And so this is where we've got a number of endpoints for manipulating this data so we can get all of the reviews. We can get an individual review by ID. And we can do, for example, have a summary of the average rating for each one of the titles across those reviews. And we've got posts and puts and things like that. And if we just run that up, we can see that it's all working. And so we get Swagger showing us what's going on. We can do something like look at all the reviews. So if we just try that out, then we get some JSON back showing us all the reviews we've got. So more than one review for each title. And then that's what feeds into the summary down the bottom here. So if we try that one out, it will run through them all and then just give us the average rating for all of the reviews for that particular book. So we can see that Dr. No has an average of 3.5. So that's our current API. And so then we may make a decision that we want to modify that. Now, there's a number of ways you can modify it. The simplest one is just to be adding a new piece of functionality. But you might also have the idea that you're going to remove functionality. Say, we're no longer able to post reviews on this interface, something like that. You might also want to modify existing functionality. Say, add a new parameter to one of those endpoints. And indeed, you might want to make a big change, like changing the entire model. So our model that we've got here, our book review, is defined with ID, title, and rating. If you added a new property in there, that would mean that pretty much all of the endpoints were going to change. And so that would be quite a big modification to your API. And we want to do that in accordance with things like the open-close principle and the interface segregation principle. So we don't want to be modifying the existing API. We want to leave that for those people who want to use it and then add a new one so that people who do want to move forward with the new features can do so. And the new feature we're going to add is simply rather like the summary we've got here, which gives us the average rating for all of the titles. We're going to have a summary that takes the title as a parameter and just gives us back the average for one of those. So it's going to be an additional new endpoint. You could argue, well, we could just add that into the existing API. It's not going to break anything because people aren't going to be using it unless they know about it. But that actually would still be a breach of the interface segregation principle, in that it would mean, if you remember the definition of the interface segregation principle, that interfaces should not have methods that clients don't use. And that would happen in this case much better if we produce a new interface with a new feature, and then those clients that want it can migrate to it. Those that don't can stick where they are. So that's what we're going to do. So let's go in there and let's do this in a very simple way to start with. Let's just add a new controller, and we're going to call this book reviews v2 version 2 controller. And then I'm going to make a slight change because I've adopted here the convention we're not going to have API slash on there. So if we look at our original one, we've just got root to the controller. So the same sort of thing here. Then what we need to do is we need to get hold of a couple of things. We need to get hold of the repository. So we'll have a private read-only iReview repository so that we can get at the data. We'll call that underscore review repository. But then additionally, we also need to get hold of the other controller, because we don't want to be repeating ourselves in terms of the functionality that's already there. So we're going to have a books review controller, call it that. Then we're going to have a constructor that will inject the repository. So we'll pop that in there and then just move that back up to where it was. Then in the constructor, as well as having the repository injected, we're also going to create the other book reviews controller and pass it the repository there. So that means we can make use of that for anything which is the same in both the old controller and the new one. And then for the most part, we're just going to delegate over. So actually, let's go in here and let's grab all of those endpoints and just paste them into the new controller. But we're not going to use those implementations because that would be code duplication. So what we then want to do is simply delegate each one of those to the existing controller. So in here, I'm just going to say return underscore book reviews controller dot get. And then we don't need to worry about anything else. And similarly, we'll do that in the get by ID. So return and then underscore book reviews controller dot. And it works it out for us. Similarly in the summary and all the way through, we can just put those in there. So for the put and for the delete. So that's got all the same functionality now in our second controller. Then we want to add some new functionality. So remember, we're going to do this as a summary for a particular title. So let's base it on what we've got there. So this is now going to be called summary for title. Change the name of the method. So that's also summary for title. And that's going to take as a parameter the title. So we'll just put that there on the root and also in the method. And then what we're going to do is we're going to say var reviews equals. And then this one, we directly access the repository because we can't get this from the other controller. And we'll say dot all reviews dot where. And then it's worked out for us where review give review dot title. So that's going to give us all the reviews matching this particular title. We've then got to worry about the fact that actually there could be nothing for that title if it's an invalid title. So we're then going to say if, and it's given us reviews dot any, but we actually want not reviews dot any. And if there aren't any, we're simply going to return a not found. And that means, of course, we've got to remember in our metadata, we've got to announce that we're returning a not found. So we can put that in there and pick the not found. And then if we have got some reviews, then we're going to say var summary equals, and we're going to have a new book review. And that's going to have a title, which is simply title, the parameters come in, but then it's going to have a rating, which is all of those reviews for this title, and then average, and then R gives R dot rating. So the rating is the average of all those ratings. And then we can simply return an OK of summary. A couple of other things we have to do though, because we're now just returning a single item, we're going to change the return type and also change the type specified in the produced response type. And so that should be that all working. So if we now run that up, we can see that Swagger is now giving us two completely separate controllers. So we've got two different APIs. We've got the original one that just has the original methods, and then we've got the new one that has all of the original methods plus the additional summary for title that we gave it there. So if we just check that out, we can see that the get all works in exactly the same way. So that just delegated through to the original controller, whereas the summary for title, that's the new one. So if we try that one out and we go for something like Goldfinger and execute that, then you can see we're just getting the average for Goldfinger. And indeed, you don't have to use Swagger, obviously. If we just take that URL and paste that in there directly, we'll still get the same result done directly. So we've kind of done it, but we haven't really done actual versioning because all we've got here is two separate APIs that happen to have similar names, and we've effectively used just a naming convention to indicate that we've got book reviews V2 and the original one that we might have changed the name to V1 or just stick with book reviews. But we can do better than that in terms of having a much clearer definition of the versioning. So that's what we're going to do here. So the first thing we're going to do is we're actually going to make it so that both of these controllers have the same name. They're both just called book reviews controller. We don't put the version in the name. Now, obviously, that's going to cause the problem because you can't have two classes with the same name in the same namespace. But we're going to fix that. We're going to put in separate folders for each of these. So let's put in a new folder that we'll call V1. And then another new folder that we'll call V2. And then let's drag those controllers in there. And say okay to that. Notice the nice thing it does, adjust namespaces for move files. So remember, that's now going to be in the namespace controllers.v1. So let's put that one in for us. Same sort of thing with v2. Drag that in there. Click OK on both of those. And so that one is now in the v2 namespace. Next thing we're going to do, though, is we're going to change the name here. So let's rename that to just being Book Reviews Controller. Exactly the same name. But that is now valid because they're in different namespaces, V1 and V2. But now we've got a bit of a problem because that's now going to be recursive. So this one, the one that we're delegating to, we have to call V1.BookReviewsController and the same down there. So that's now what we're delegating to. So that's now given them the same name, put them in separate folders, and it should still be working. If we run that one up, however, then we can see we're getting a problem. And it's not just a problem with Swagger. This is not going to work at all. So if we now go to a different tab and paste in that URL we had before, get rid of that V2 because it's now just going to be book reviews. So summary for title for Goldfinger. That one actually works. So that's not a problem. The problem is if we just went for something like bookreviews/summary, that gives us a problem because it can't tell which one we're supposed to be working with. So the routing's failed because there are two things with exactly the same route. So now we need to make some changes to that as well to get that to work. So what we now need to do is actually introduce a NuGet package that is going to help us out with it. So if we go in here and just do a search on mvc.versioning, that gives us the package to give us the versioning information. So let's install that. And then the next thing we need to do is configure that. So we'll go into our program and in here, we're going to say builder.services. And then add API versioning. So that's been introduced with that new package. And that takes some options. So we'll put in those options. And the options we can go for, we'll talk about the details of these maybe in a later video. But the simple ones we're going to go for, we're going to say options.defaultApiVersion. And then we're going to say equals new API version. And let's get rid of the namespace there and just put it in as you're using. And then this takes two parameters, which are the major version and the minor version. So that's the degree of control we've got, major and minor. So it's going to be version 1.0. So we're defaulting it back to the original because that means that anybody who was working on the original will not have their functionality changed. They'll stick with what they've got. Let's also do a few other things. So we're going to say options dot and then assume defaulted version when unspecified. So again, that's kind of related to the same thing, that it means that anybody who is unaware of the change and doesn't include a version, they're just going to get the one that they want. And then we're also going to say options dot and then report API version set to true. And that means that when a request is made to this API, we're going to get sent back in the response header information to say what versions are actually available, so that anybody using it can see that there may be a newer version for them. Then we need to make some changes to the controllers themselves. So we'll go to the original one, the version one, and on there, I'm going to firstly add the version information. So we're going to put another attribute, which is going to be API version, and this is going to be version 1.0. And so that's specifying the version there. And then also, we're going to have to specify what the route is going to be, including the version. So I'm going to take that existing route, and then we're going to change that. So we're going to say V for version, and then we're going to have curly braces, and we're going to say version colon API version. So that means that it's going to automatically insert the version number after the V there. So this is actually going to be V1/book reviews. We could have hard coded that. We could have used a different convention other than just having a V there, but that's the simplest way to do it. So it'll take basically the 1.0 from there and it will put it in there. So that's where we're going to go. You'll notice though, we leave the original route in there. So both of these routes will take us to this version one controller. And that again is for backwards compatibility. So anybody who was accessing it by the old route doesn't have to upgrade. That will just stay the same. We're then going to take that and we're going to put it into the version 2 with some slight changes. So we're going to change that obviously to 2.0. Leave that exactly the same, that's fine. But then we're going to remove that one because we're not defaulting to 2.0, we're defaulting to 1.0. And so those are the changes that we need to make there. And if we run that one up, we're still failing on the swagger, but the rest of it should be working okay. So if we go to localhost/bookreviews, then that, remember, is doing the get, and it's doing the get on the version 1 controller because that was the default. And we can demonstrate that if we just go into Visual Studio, go to the version 1 controller, and go to the get for that, and then just run that again. We can see that's what we're hitting there. Similarly, if I were to change that to /v1/bookreviews, then we hit the same one again, because although we could go with the default, we can also go with the name. But if I were to put in another breakpoint on the get for v2, which remember is just delegating to v1, but it's going through our new controller, then in that case, if I change that to v2, then we hit the v2 controller, which then delegates through to the v1 controller, and that then gives us our result in exactly the same way. You could also actually put in v2.0 there, and it will still do the same thing. So if you've got 0 as your minor version, then you don't have to put it in, but you can, so we can do that with v2.0. But what we can obviously do as well is we can now on this one do /summary for title/Goldfinger, and that's working as well. So our version 2 has the summary for title, which obviously our version 1 is not going to have. And that's the whole point that we've separated these two out. So we have now got our two different versions, version 1, version 2, of this particular API with the addition or whatever changes we wanted to make. And while we're here, we can just take a quick look using the dev tools at what was coming in there. So if I refresh that, there we can see Goldfinger. If I click on that and look at the headers and just scroll down a little, there you can see in the response headers, we've got that API supported versions 1.0 and 2.0, which is what I configured it to do in the program when we had that report API versions. So we've got all of that working, all of that information being reported, but what we haven't got, and we're going to see this in the next video, we haven't got Swagger working with this because there's a fair bit more work to put that together. So next time, we're going to look at how to make Swagger work and also look at a few other details of what we can do with the versioning. So hope you found that helpful. If you did, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time to look at how we can make that work with Swagger.